Hello friends, this is DK Gautam and thank you for joining Interview Point.
In this video, I am going to discuss about top 15 ASP.NET Core interview questions. So guys, these are the very important interview questions, so you must have to prepare before going for the ASP.NET Core interview. Okay guys, so let's get started. So first question comes here, what is ASP.NET Core? ASP.NET Core is a new version of ASP.NET and it is an open source. It is not an upgraded version of ASP.NET, it's completely rewritten. Okay, so it is cross-platform, supporting Windows, Mac OS and Linux, and can be used in device, cloud and embedded IoT scenarios. The next point is it can work with both .NET Core and also .NET Framework via the .NET standard framework. It is best suitable for developing cloud-based such as web applications, mobile application, IoT application. Next one is command line support to create, build and run the application. So here the .NET Core, there is a command line support to create, build and run the application. So the next question is, what are the features, characteristics provided by the ASP.NET Core? Or this question may be asked by the, what is the advantages of ASP.NET Core? Okay, so here the characteristics, or we can say features. Okay, so it is a single programming module for MVC and web API. So guys, here we are not creating multiple projects for web API and MVC. Here only one application we can use for ASP.MVC core or web API part. Okay, the next one is support WebSocket and Signal R. Command line support to create, build and run the application, and built-in support for logging framework, and it can be extensible. Next one is it has good support for asynchronous programming, and also there is no web.config file. We can store the custom configuration into the fsettings.json files. Here guys, here there is no web.config file available. We are having fsettings.json file and a startup. We will talk about the startup and program.cs file. Okay, so the next one is there is no global.asax file. We can now register and use the services into startup class. Okay guys, multiple hosting ways are supported. We will talk about it later. The next point is provide protection against CSRF, is nothing but cross-site request forgery. Next point is built-in support for dependencies injection. So guys, this is the very important point here, dependency injection. So here in the .NET Core, we are having this much of features. Okay, so the next question comes here, what is dependency injection? So guys, I have already made one video on the dependency injection. Please watch that video. So because I'm not going to explain here everything, because this video will take time. So this question will take time, so that's why I will not explain here, but I will tell you here some points. Dependency injection, or we can say DI, is a software design pattern. It is a technique for achieving inversion of control, IOC, between classes and their dependencies. The next point is it allows us to develop loosely coupled code. Okay, and it makes code maintainable. It also helps us to reduce the tight coupling between software components. So dependency injection enables us to better manage future changes and other complex in our software development. Okay, so the next question comes here, what is the role of startup class? So guys, startup class is the entry point of the ASP.NET Core. So here we can see this is web API core project. I have already worked with this, so I hope you already watched this video, CRUD operation with ASP.NET Core. If you haven't watched, please watch that. So here guys, we are having a startup class. So this class is the starting point of this application. Actually, we are not having here main method, so you will have a doubt. So why this is the startup class? Actually here program class is the startup object, but here in program class what we are having, we are having main method. So this is the exactly this is the startup object, but we call startup.cs file as a startup. Why? That is the reason, because in the main method what we are having, we are calling this method create host builder. So in this method what we are calling here, we are calling the startup.cs file, startup class. Okay guys, so that's why we are saying startup.cs is the starting point, but we can change it. Okay, it is not mandatory that we must have that startup.cs file here. Okay, it is not mandatory. So a startup class is not mandatory, you can have anything. Okay guys, so here next point is it is not necessary that class name must be startup, it can be anything. We can configure startup class in the program class. So that's why we are saying that in the program class we are configuring. Okay, so we are configuring this class. Okay guys, so the next point is it is responsible for configuration related things as below. So the point is here, it configure the services which are required by application. Now let's see, here we are configuring the services here. Okay, this is the nothing nothing but this is the dependency injection. I will tell you. So here, what it is? It is nothing but it is an interface, and this is the service. And this class is implementing this service. So what we are doing here? We are adding our services into the dependency injection container here. Okay, guys. So this is the it configure the services which are required by the application. It defines the application request handling pipeline as a series of middleware components. So this is the very important here. Okay, so this help us to for the dependency injection. And let's see here in the employee control what we are doing here. We have just created one private read only variable by using this. And what we are doing here, we are passing this variable I interface, and by using this constructor we are injecting this upon dependency. Okay, so this is ready for us. So now, and that's why it is providing a loosely coupled. So that's why we are saying it is loosely coupled here. A startup class is specified inside create host builder method when host is created. So here we are having create host builder, this one. Okay, so it is defined here in startup class. Multiple startup classes can also be defined for different environments. At runtime, appropriate startup class is used. Okay, so the next question is, what is the role of configure services and configure methods? So this is very important question, guys. So like as you can see here in the startup class, we are having two methods, configure services and also configure method. So we are talking about here, what is the difference between these two methods? Okay, so configure services method is optional and defined inside the startup class. It takes care of registering services that are consumed across the application using dependency injection or application services. So in the configure service method, we are choosing for the dependency injection. Okay, so the next point is, it's get called by host before configure method to configure the application services. Next one is, what is the configure method? Configure method is used to add middleware components to I application builder. This is the interface instance that's available in configure method. Here you can see here I application builder, and we are using this instance here. Okay, in the configure method, so it accepts I application builder as a parameter. We can see here it is a parameter, I application builder, and also it has two optional parameters, I hosting environment and I logger factory. We can also here we can have I logger factory. Okay, so we have to create using this namespace microsoft.extension.login. okay, so this is here optional, we are not using here, so let's remove it. I just showed you using this method. We can configure build in middleware such as routing, authentication, session, etc, as well as third party middleware. So in this method we can configure all the things. Okay, so like we are using here use http as redirection, use routing, use authorization. So we can also use here app dot use session. Okay, so the next point is configure method also specifies how the app responds to HTTP request and response. The next question is, what is the www root folder in ASP.NET Core? So this is very important question also in ASP.NET Core. So by default, the www root is the root folder that contains the static files such as HTML, CSS and JavaScript. The files can be stored here and accessed with a relative path to the root. Only these files inside the www root can be served over HTTP request. All other files are filtered out and cannot be served by default. So the next question is, what is middleware? This is also very important question, guys. So a middleware is nothing but a component class which is executed on every request in ASP.NET Core application. It is a software which is injected into the application pipeline to handle request and responses. So guys, I already talked about here, we are injecting this. Okay, so what is this? This is all about the middleware components. Okay guys, I will explain here. So middleware components is program that's built into an application pipeline to handle the request and response. Each middleware component can decide whether to pass the request to the next component and to perform any operation before or after next component in pipeline. It is used to implement several tasks when handling request. Okay, so let's understand here on the Microsoft documentation here. Create a middleware pipeline here. So what we are using here, I application builder. The ASP.NET Core request pipeline consists of a sequence of request delegates called one after the other. The following diagram demonstrates the concept and date of execution flows and black arrows. So here what is the request is coming here. We are having middleware 1, middleware 2 and middleware. So this is the next method here. We have to write here our logic. Here is the next. In the middleware 2 we also have the next method. Like this, this is the working process of the middleware, okay, middleware pipeline. So here it is providing a response to the user. Okay, so this is all about the middleware. So guys, actually this is the very big question and you have to prepare very well. If I will get time, I will make separate video about this and I will provide the link into the chart. What is the difference between .NET Core framework and .NET Standard? So .NET Standard is a specification for implementing the base class library BCL. BCL is classes such as exception handling, XML collections, input, output, and networking. WPF, WCF, and ASP.NET do not form part of BCL and so are not included in .NET Standard Library. .NET Core is a managed framework that builds desktop and web application in cross-platform. Both .NET Core and .NET Framework include .NET Standard or BCL base class library in their managed framework. .NET Framework is a framework that builds desktop and web application in Windows only. Okay, it is highly dependent on the architecture. So guys, this is a very important question. What is Kestrel? So guys, I hope you already heard about the IIS. So this is something called server. Kestrel is a cross-platform web server for ASP.NET Core based on Libvue, a cross-platform synchronous input-output library. Kestrel is the web server that is included by default in ASP.NET Core new project template. So guys, this is why default included with the ASP.NET Core application whenever you are going to create a new project of ASP.NET Core. So it is fast and secure and can even be used without a reverse proxy server. However, it is still recommended to use with IIS, Nginx, or Apache. Okay, a reverse proxy server receives HTTP requests from the internet and forwards them to the Kestrel after some preliminary handling. Kestrel is relatively new and does not yet have a full component of defenses against attacks. So the next question is, what is the difference between iApplicationBuilder.use and iApplicationBuilder.run method? Okay, so here we can use both the method in configure methods of a startup class. So guys, we can use both the method here in the configure, inside the configure method. Both are used to add middleware delegate to the application request pipeline. So the middleware adds using iApplicationBuilder.use may call the next middleware in the pipeline, whereas the middleware adds using iApplicationBuilder.run method never calls that subsequent or next middleware. Okay, the next point is, after iApplicationBuilder.run method, system stop adding middleware in request pipe. So the next question is, what is the difference between services.addTransient and service.addScope and service.addSingleton method are ASP.NET Core? Okay, so guys, this is very important question. If I will get time, I will make separate video on it also. So that is very important and you have to understand and you have to prepare very well this question before going for the interview. Transient objects are created for every request whenever the requested. The service can be added addTransient using addTransient method of iServiceSelection. This lifetime can be used in stateless service and it is a way to add lightweight service. So the scoped method. Scoped is nothing but scoped objects are the same within a request but different across different requests. ASP.NET Core will create and share an instance of the service per request to the application. It will create a new instance in the new request. The service can be added as scoped using the scoped method of iServiceSelection. So here guys, here is the typo. Here will be the THE. So the next one is singleton. Singleton object created the first time they are requested or when configure service is run and an instance is specified with a service registration. The service can be added as a singleton using addSingleton method of iServiceSelection. ASP.NET Core creates service instance at the time of registration and subsequent requests use this service instance. So guys, next question is, what is WebListener? Again, this is again also a web server. WebListener is a web server in ASP.NET Core that runs only on Windows hosting machine. Okay, Windows host machine. It is an alternative to Kestrel. So we cannot, if we don't want to use Kestrel, then we can use web listener, but it is only for the Windows host machine. It is an alternative to Kestrel and built on HTTP SYS Kestrel mode driver. Also, it is used for direct connection to the internet without the need of an IIS as a reverse proxy server. It is not compatible with IIS. The next question is, what are the various JSON files available in ASP.NET Core? Following JSON files are available in ASP.NET Core. There are so many files available. So let's understand. AppSettings.json file, BundleConfig.json file, LaunchSettings.json file, Power.json, Package.json, and Global.json file. So these are the files available in ASP.NET Core. Okay. Explain routing in ASP.NET Core. So guys, I already made video on routing. It is not different in our previous ASP.NET MVC application. This is same as previously. So I will provide you the link in the iCard so you can check this video. Routing is a functionality that map incoming request to the route handler. The routing uses route or map incoming request with route handler and generate URL that used in response. The route can have value, extract them from URL that's used to process a request. Using the route, routing can find route handler based on URL. All the routes are registered when the application is started. There are two types of routing supported by ASP.NET Core. The conventional routing and attribute. Actually, there are two types of routing available, conventional based routing and attribute based routing. So the next and last question is, how to enable session in ASP.NET Core? So guys, this PPT, I will provide you the link in the description of this video. So you can get this PPT from the video description. Okay, so do not worry about it. So this is also again very important, how to enable session in ASP.NET Core. The middleware of session is provided by the package microsoft.asp.net4.session. To use the session in ASP.NET Core application, we need to add this package to this project file and add the session middleware to ASP.NET Core request pipeline. So we can add here the middleware in app.use session like this. Okay, there is no big deal. Okay, like this we can add. So the next point is, here we are using the session like this, app.session. Okay, I hope you understand this video. I hope guys you enjoyed this video. We'll see you in the next video. If you have any doubt, you can ask me through comment, and don't forget to provide the feedback. That your feedback is very important for me to improve the quality of the video. Okay guys, we'll see you in the next video. Till then, take care and good luck.
So thanks for watching this video guys. Please subscribe our YouTube channel. If you haven't subscribed, you can follow me on Facebook, Twitter and LinkedIn. This is my blog URL. You can check it out. Guys, if you have any doubt, you can ask me through comment. Please provide your feedback. Thanks.